let's look at this question. If a, b, c are real and x minus a into x minus b plus x minus b into x minus c plus x minus c into x minus a is equal to 0, then how many of the following statements are true? Okay, let's look at the first question, first statement. The roots of this equation are always real. Maybe true, maybe not. The second, the roots of this equation are imaginary if a plus b is greater than equal to 2c. Maybe true, maybe not, I don't know. The roots of this equation are equal if a is equal to b is equal to c. Can you see straight away? Can you see straight away? A is equal to b is equal to c. X minus a, x minus b. If a was equal to b was equal to c, you would effectively get, turn everything into a. You would get x minus a whole square is equal to 0, or the only roots for a would, x would be a comma a. So this statement 3 is definitely true. Now the fourth statement is the roots of this equation are always imaginary. Okay, at this time, can you see that either statement 1 or statement 2 will always be true? Because this is a quadratic expression. This is an expression in x square. Either both the roots will be real or both the roots will be imaginary. So the roots of this equation are always imaginary or roots of this equation are always real. Both of them cannot simultaneously be true. One of them is false, one of them is true. Okay, so let me check. I would have to open these brackets up and see. First expression, okay, let me run. I will get x square minus x times of a plus b plus ab. Because all the expressions are similar, x square minus x of b plus c plus bc, x square minus x of a plus c plus ac. This entire thing is equal to 0. So this turns into 3x square minus 2x a plus b plus c plus ab plus bc plus ac. This is equal to 0. Now I have to check if the roots of this x, the roots of this expression of x is real or unreal. So using the discriminant part, I would get 4 times of a plus b plus c whole square minus 12 times of, let's see, 3 into 4, 12 times of ab plus bc plus ca. Okay, I have to see if this is greater than equal to 0 or less than equal to 0, or there is a conditional case where midway it becomes this. So if I open up the brackets, I get 4a square plus 4b square plus 4c square plus 8ab plus 8bc plus 8ca minus 12ab minus 12bc minus 12ca. Okay, this is disheartening. Can I get 4a square plus 4b square plus 4c square minus 4? Am I going to do it correctly so far? Seems like it. Minus 4ab minus 4bc minus 4. See it. Okay. Seems like everything is fine. Now I have a term which is 4ab, I have a term which is 4bc, I have a term which is 4ca. In order to make sure whether this is greater than or equal to 0, I would have to turn it into perfect squares. So how can I do it? Let me break this down into 2a square and 2a square. This into 2b square and 2b square. This into 2c square and 2c square. See what terms am I taking now? This plus this and this should give me a perfect square. Root 2a minus root 2b, what will be the square of this? These three terms, 2a square, 2b square, when you multiply this, 2 into 2, 2, yes, this works. Again, and plus, let me take this now, and this now, root 2a minus root 2c whole square. Works wonderfully well. So taken care of, 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 taken care of. The only thing that is left is 2b square, 2c square, and 4bc. I can again write it down as root 2b minus root 2c whole square. And in fact, all the expressions here are turning into some perfect square. If it, all the expressions are turning into some perfect square, this will necessarily be greater than or equal to 0. And if all the, if all of this will be necessarily greater than or equal, the roots of the equation will always be here. This is also true. And if this is true, this becomes false, this becomes false, the answer to the question will be 2. 2 of the given 4 statements are correct. Okay.